Hey, little fella.
Oh, you're a cutie.
Hey, Persis, what's your mouse's name?
Name? It doesn't have a name. It's just food for the snake.
Persis, that snake didn't happen to be poisonous, did it?
Yeah, deadly poison.
You gotta get a tourniquet. You gotta cut open the wound. You gotta suck out the poison.
Yeah, but you could cut into a nerve and end up making things worse. What you need is antivenom.
Antivenom? Yeah, that's what I need, antivenom.
That brings up an interesting question. What is antivenom, and how does it save you from a poisonous bite?
Well, let's start with the venom itself. Venom is a highly specialized saliva, which has taken millions of years to evolve. It's injected when a venomous animal bites into its prey. The venom either stuns or kills the victim.
Just lay still. Don't move your arm. Just spread the poison around faster. Don't worry. The ambulance will be here soon.
I can feel the poison coursing through my veins. I'm a goner.
So what does the venom do once it gets inside your body? Well, that depends on the type of venom. There are basically two types. Those that contain neurotoxins and those that contain hemotoxins. Neurotoxins attack your nervous system. If you could look inside your body, your nervous system would look something like this. Nerve fibers are like the electrical wiring that threads through your house. But neurotoxins damage these nerve fibers and prevent signals from getting through. This can have some serious consequences. Neurotoxins cause muscle cramps, twitching, vomiting, convulsions, paralysis. But things get really bad when the neurotoxins attack your vagus nerve. This is the nerve that controls your breathing. If it doesn't work, you could suffocate.
Do you mind sparing me the gruesome details, please?
Wait, I haven't told you about hemotoxins. Hemotoxins attack your red blood cells. A red blood cell is like one of these chocolates. It has a protective outer coating that acts as a container for a gooey mixture inside. This goo is rich in oxygen. The oxygen gets transported along your bloodstream to every part of your body. But hemotoxins eat away at this outer layer, causing the oxygen inside to spill out. If you lose too many red blood cells, oxygen can no longer get to the rest of your body. So even if your lungs are working perfectly, you could still suffocate. You want one?
No, thanks.
Your body doesn't take this abuse lying down, however. It does try to defend itself. When venom floods into your bloodstream, your body reacts by producing special cells called antibodies. These antibodies seek out and destroy the venom. But making antibodies takes time. Your body can't manufacture them fast enough to win the battle.
Well, thank you very much for that insightful explanation, Persis.
No problem.
Finally.
Are you the one bitten by the snake?
Yeah, that would be me.
Better get on the antivenom.
Right.
So what's with this antivenom stuff? Well, believe it or not, this is actually made from venom.
What? Venom?
The manufacture of antivenom is a complicated process. It starts here with the collection of venom. This is no easy task. It takes 10 timber rattlesnakes just to get one teaspoon of venom. But how does this venom become antivenom? Well, you start by injecting the venom into a horse.
A horse? Yep, a horse. Remember when I told you about antibodies? How your body can't produce enough of them? So if you had more antibodies, you could fight off the venom, right? What you need is an antibody factory. No, not like that. Like this. some venom in here. Not a fatal dose, just a little. The horse's body will react and begin to produce antibodies to fight off the venom. It acts like an antibody factory. But why not a cow or a sheep? Why a horse? Well, you can use other animals, even humans, but it's simply a matter of size. The bigger the factory, the more antibodies you get for your buck. And the more antibodies you get, the more antivenom you get. That's because the antibodies extracted from here are the key ingredients in this stuff. This ready-made supply of antibodies is just the shot in the arm your body needs to win that battle against venom.
This won't hurt a bit.
Remember, Mike, this is a one-shot deal. Antivenom will not make you immune for life. If you get bitten again, you're going to need another shot of antivenom.
There, that wasn't so bad. Here, hold this.